Hey, it's John from Enduring Charm. You know, I have a bunch of fans and heaters that are pretty cheap. These are like 20 bucks a pop, something like that. And you don't get very long at them before, I bet you'll notice that these fans start to either seize up or get kind of rattly, and they don't really work right without making a racket. Because they're so cheap, they're really just designed to be thrown out. But there is a way to extend the life. And I guess you could do some maintenance on it too from time to time if you have these for a long period. I've had these heaters here, these kind of utility heaters, which sell now for 20, 25 bucks. I've had them for, gosh, I don't know, 5, 6 years. And I keep one in my shop all winter running constantly. And there's a way to keep them running so that you get some more life out of them. And if you have a fan like this one I have here where it's just it just gets rattly when you run it, there's a way to fix that too. So I'm going to show you that today. All right, if you want to try to keep these things going, and you know, I'd be the first to admit I'm pretty tight with money. I mean, they're 20 bucks, right? Throw it out, get a new one. But I'm so tight I squeak when I walk. So what I do is first get this thing apart. Most of these things are put together with you know, Phillips screws, sometimes Torx, but in this case it was Phillips screws. So I get the cover off. On this heater over here, again, I just remove the back cover. And this one I haven't touched yet, but it's all full of sawdust. This was in the shop. So it's all caked with dirt. And so the first thing I want to do is just blow that out. I use compressed air. So I have an air hose, you know, and you have one of these blower guns on there. So you can take that outside, blow the dust out. If you don't have that, you can wipe it potentially. Maybe use you know, an aerosol spray that you can buy for computers, that sort of thing. But compressed air is definitely the easiest way of doing it if you have it. All right, I have a close-up here of the heater. I'm going to start with this just because it's easier to show you. So I've blown out all the dust, or most of it anyway. And what's important to understand is the construction of these things. Obviously, this is unplugged now, by the way. So in this case, I have a heater. So over here, my heater coils, all right? They just get, they're just basically big resistors, and they heat up and they get hot. And then you have this fan right here, which blows across those coils, and that's what, you know, brings your heat out. So all these are basically built the same way. You have a little armature in here, which is just a motor. If you have basic motor theory, you know how those things work, right? And instead of a bearing, they all have a bushing, or two bushings, actually. So in the back here, this one, this particular one, you could actually take apart, but I'm not going to. So in the back right here, this shaft, so here's the fan blade, here's the shaft right here, that shaft goes right through, and in the back here is a bushing, which is just basically, it's usually brass or something soft like that, a soft metal like that. That is a surface for the shaft to rub against. So instead of ball bearings where they roll around, you just have that bushing there, and it needs to be lubricated. In the front here, somewhere in this area, okay, is another bushing, which does most of the work. So this bushing in the back basically keeps the shaft aligned from going back and forth like this. The bushing here in the front takes more of the load. And actually, let me see if I can show you. I can actually take this fan. This one, I'm not sure you'll be able to see this on camera, but you can actually see, if you look right here, you can see it moving back and forth a little bit. It's very loosely built. So the armature can move in and out. In this case, it's about, I don't know, 1.5 millimeters, something like that. And what happens is those bushings, because they don't have much lubrication to start with, dry up, and that's when this will either seize or start getting rattly because the bushing itself is wearing out. It is a soft metal, and once the lubrication goes away, then there's not much to stop it from just wearing itself out. So what I started doing was just lubricating this with an oil. Now this particular motor, I could take these, maybe I will actually, you could take these off, these two screws here, and this whole thing would come off and I could get some real good lubrication in there. Let me show you the other fan, and that's a little bit different, but same idea. All right, here's a close-up of the fan. So right here is the fan blade. So you can see that spin, right? Now this fan, what's happened is the bushing has just worn out or become very warm. But let me just show you here. This is easier to see on this one, I think. see how much that armature moves if I'm looking right down in here, okay? And see how much that armature moves back and forth? Now, that's fairly normal, but the more wear it gets, the more that'll move back and forth. And right down, let me get my pointer, right down in here is the bushing, where that pointer is. And that's the main one. There's going to be another one on the bottom. But this is the one where you need to get some lubrication. So what I've ended up doing is you could use something like WD-40 or something like that for lubrication, but it's a really lightweight oil and it's not going to last very long. It's going to evaporate and it's going to be done. So I've taken to using like a 3-in-1 oil, or you could even use a motor oil if you want. And the trick is getting it in there. So the old 3-in-1 oil, which has been sold for a million years, is a good choice for this. But this particular packaging is good because it has a telescoping wand to it. So it goes way high. It's like 6 inches high. And it really gives you the ability to get into that tight space, which is really the main problem. So this is what I've been using. But another option would be to take like a Q-tip and dip the Q-tip in a motor oil. And then you could use that Q-tip to get into the area where we need to get. But I'm going to use this stuff and I'll show you how I do it. All right, back to a close-up of the fan here. I have the camera like directly in my way here. I'm going to try to show you. So I'm taking this telescoping wand. Where is it? There it is. And what I want to do is just get it touching the shaft. Whoop, I already got oil everywhere. Touching the shaft and just drop a little oil in there. You don't have to kill it, but just enough to... It's got some air in it, so I got to let the air out. All right. And what you want to avoid is you don't really want to get oil dripping everywhere where it gets into the armature and the electric part of it. That would not be good. So what I do is just let it soak. You'll notice that the shaft is on an angle right now so that gravity is going to want to feed this oil down. And so I just get it on the shaft, turn the fan a little bit, and just let it soak in. Now, by doing this, I'm probably not going to get to the bottom bushing, but that's really not the problem because this main one up top is what takes most of the load. So if I can get this part lubricated, and I'll move it back and forth and just make sure I work that in there. All right, for this one, this is the heater now. I could do what I just did on the fan. I could just drip some oil. Actually, I could get to the back bushing by dripping oil in here, and I could get to the front bushing by dripping oil in here. And that probably is all I need to do. But what the heck, since I just noticed this particular one has this little bracket here, and I should be able to get this bushing off. Let's just see for the hell of it what this does. So I'm just taking a Phillips screwdriver. And we'll see what we can take apart here. I think this is just going to take the back bracket off. There's one. This may go through further than I think. All right, so that's that. Yeah, there you go. So this particular one, I'll try to get a close-up here. So that is my bushing right there. Now, because I'm able to take this totally apart, I'll clean this up a little more because there's still some dust in there I could get out. And I could lubricate this with a grease. Now, I'd have to use a very lightweight grease because if I use too heavy a grease, it'll just stop the motor from turning. But like a light lithium grease I could use, a silicone grease, sometimes designed for bicycles, I could use that. Or I could just stick with the oil, which is fine too. So I'm going to clean this up with a paper towel and put some... I think I'll probably just use oil, some oil in there. But this is the shaft right here, and here is the bushing. All right, because I have this back bushing off, it gives me an opportunity to get in here if camera's in my way as usual. I'm just going to drip some oil in there. And because this gives me more free play than I would otherwise have, well, one more drip, give it to me. One more. There it is. Now I can actually push this back and forth and make sure I get oil into that bushing. And it wouldn't be too much effort to take this apart the rest of the way, but it's really not worth it. There, that way I'm sure then I'm getting the bushing itself lubricated because I can move the shaft that much. All right, and then I'll just take the back here that I was able to take apart on this particular motor, which is usually not the case, and I am just going to use a little bit of oil. I don't think it's really worth it for the grease. All right, and then I can put this back together. That's a little bit too much. All right, I'll put this back together, and I should be good to go. All right, let's see how I did. This fan, before I put the oil in there, was just about, it was almost seized. You would turn it on, it would rattle for a minute, and then it would just stop turning. So we should be in better shape now. So let's see if the proof is in the pudding. I have it plugged in. Beautiful. Quiet. No problem at all. Try a different speed. Yeah, beautiful. So that works great. So now I just put that cover back on, and I'm good to go. Now the heater is over here. I have this apart still just to make sure I can show it to you. So I'm gonna reach around and get the fan to turn on. I don't wanna leave this on too long because it does have heat. And I'm gonna find the button, there it is. There, sorry about that. It took me a minute to find the button. Yeah, that's nice and smooth and quiet too. It's quieter than it used to be. So I have two more of these fans. I'm just gonna, let me reach around and turn this off so I don't burn something up here. I'm gonna take them apart. They're not in bad shape yet, but actually one of these last year had actually seized. The motor stopped running totally. That was one I had left on literally nonstop for like 3 months. But I oiled it up and it worked fine again. So I'm going to take the other two apart and just as a preventative maintenance kind of thing, just give them some more oil and they should be good to go for many years to come.